1911, and you'll notice the woodwork in here.
Wally Wirt has spent his life around trains.
I've been involved in restoration of railroad cars for probably 40 years.
Streetcar number 25 has been restored by the Rocky Mountain Railroad Club. This car ran on the Denver and Intermountain Railroad beginning in 1911.
The DNIM, or Denver Intermountain, originally ran from Denver out to Golden, and it was constructed for passenger service.
By the 1910s, Denver suburbs were growing quickly, and the streetcars provided critical transportation.
A lot of the roads in the streetcar era weren't even paved, so the streetcar made a handy way to get to Lakeside Park, to go downtown, do a number of different things.
It's one of a handful of early Denver streetcars still in existence.
Right here, what they call the truss rods.
Underneath the protective tarp sits another Denver Tramway Car 0.04.
The knee brace is still in original tramway yellow.
It's one Wally would like to see restored as well.
And the 04 ran to Arvada and also ran on a separate line to Golden, and it also went out to the mining district in Leyden.
0.04's claim to fame isn't so much where it ran, but when.
Well, that was technically the very last streetcar that ever ran in Denver in revenue service.
After the war, Denver began to grow at a fever pitch, and the streetcars couldn't keep up.
It's very hard to extend a streetcar line. It's very easy to extend a bus line.
New buses meant the end of the line for the streetcars, and 0.04 would be the last man standing.
The 04 was sent out to Leyden at the end of the line, and they didn't get back into Denver until about 12:03 in the morning after all the other cars had been suspended.
The era of the streetcar quietly came to an end. 60 years later, a renewed interest in rail transit has rekindled interest in the past.
And it's sort of the idea that what goes around comes around with regard to transit.
RTD's Gold Line runs through Arvada as the streetcar tracks did many years ago. Returning 04 to Arvada appeals to many.
That's kind of an appropriate way to honor the transportation heritage of Arvada and the streetcar system itself.
We have pictures of the car in Arvada. We know it was in service there. So it seemed like the first and best place for this car. Let's send it home.
Restoring it, though, is no easy task.
The roof materials are in pretty bad shape. There's significant rot in different places in the car.
And we had to wrap it up to keep it from falling apart.
Allison Harper worked on an architectural assessment of the car.
The bones are in good shape, so it can be saved. It just needs a lot of work. And they really ran them until the end of their life and patched them with plywood and just tried to keep them going as long as they could.
Well, there's no intent to operate the car. We really want to do what they call a cosmetic restoration.
A large percentage of the ceiling will be replaced. Most of the windows, all the bottoms are deteriorated.
John Russell worked on number 25. He hopes to do the same for 0.04.
It's a labor of love. It's understanding and how it was put together in the first place so that it can be replicated.
Once restored, the plan is to display the car near an RTD station in Arvada, providing a link to the past.
It's so historic. It's such a important part of Denver's history as the last streetcar to run.
It's a tangible link to our history, and it's important to show where we were so we know where we've been.